Hello and welcome back to Creating Creative Fulfillment. The semester just started, so I'm putting myself on an every other week schedule with these things until I can find a way to get ahead. It's not stressful, it's fun, and I'm gonna try to keep it fun and not stressful for as long as I can. And that's a pretty good segue into today's topic. It's been said before, though I can't remember if I explicitly stated it in the book. I probably did. I think I did, or at least one of the YouTube experts definitely did, that it can be dangerous turning something that you love doing into your living, or at least upgrading it from simply just hobby status. You can fall out of love with it or dread doing it, and then you lose that precious creative fulfillment you once had. So one method to avoid that is to start your creative fulfillment adventure by doing something new. And what do I mean by that? Well, ask yourself, is there a hobby you've always wanted to try or do? Has there ever been a time when you've said, I wish there was a podcast or a video series that did this or discussed that? Is there a hobby you had when you were younger that you've let go to the wayside? Is there a hobby you have now you wish you spent more time with? I'm sure you've come up with an answer to at least one of those questions. I know I came up with several things while working on this script, but I'll need to put those ideas on hold temporarily while I work on marketing this little guy, though I do hope I can get to them soon. Ironically, it's editing a novel that's currently at the top of my list. I never thought I would say that, but after a year of putting this together and living in a firmly non-fiction world, I miss my original characters. Sometimes whatever you come up with helps determine what your creative activity of choice will be. Is it a blog, a vlog, a podcast, an Instagram page, a live streaming adventure, something else, or a combination of several of these? If your new hobby or area of interest doesn't have an audio or visual component, or you want to remain more unidentifiable, start a blog or a social media account. If what you want to do can be written as an article, don't overthink it. Just write an article. But depending on what you want to do and your own comfort level, you can try different mediums to find what's best for you and where you might find your new audience. For example, if I wanted to share my progress on learning a new musical instrument, which I do think is a good place to start if you want to try this new hobby for creative fulfillment method, but I digress. Plus, I'm a little biased. I could write about my thoughts, share pictures, or record myself playing. I can share all these things on my social media platform of choice. I can put them all together to make a scripted video on YouTube. I can become more in-depth with my thoughts and create a diary of sorts through a blog. And why would I do this to myself? For some people, having a record of progress to look back on is motivation. If you're lucky, you'll find an audience that doesn't mind listening to your awkward attempts to play the instrument they've played for years. They might like your insights. If you don't have a teacher, though I'd always recommend a teacher if you can afford one who's a good fit for you, they can offer tips. You might teach yourself more than just the musical instrument. You might gain discipline, improve your writing skills, and add confidence. And that was just one example. The number of hobbies and areas of interest out there is pretty endless. So think about it. What was that one weird thing you were obsessed with in high school? You know you had something. Maybe you liked 1970s football trivia. Maybe you liked 13th century French art. Maybe you were just really into mollusks. But you never got to take that class in college. You didn't find the right workshop. You haven't stumbled yet onto that side of Twitter, Tumblr, or Reddit. So take it upon yourself and learn something new. Really immerse yourself in this topic. Try, fail, succeed, document. To really keep yourself accountable, share something publicly. You don't have to get a tattoo to maintain dedication to your new hobby. Chapter 8, links to purchase in the description. But knowing that there are people out there watching and waiting for your progress could be motivation enough. So at the end of this, what do you have? You have a new hobby you enjoy doing. You are hopefully on your way to creative fulfillment. And you haven't sacrificed your favorite hobby and turned it into a dreaded task. Of course, it's never as simple as that, and people can fall in and out of love with hobbies all the time. But hopefully this video gave you one way of looking at how to get started with this creative journey without the fear of destroying the thing you love the most. Just something to think about. As always, thanks for watching, see you next time, and remember, embrace your creative side.